Okay, week 16 of Back to Viz Basics. I'll be honest, not one of my favorite weeks. Building a Sankey diagram, which are relatively easy to create in Flourish, which is great. But I find them generally hard to read unless you've got some really cool content. I've got a couple of really good examples in my book, Better Data Visualizations, but they're kind of rare that you're going to find like the perfect content for a Sankey. But let's see what we've got. We're just learning. We're learning some Flourish. We're learning some good stuff. Let's see what we got. Okay, so here's what we're going to create, a Sankey diagram. And for this week, they give us the built-in Superstore data from Tableau. As I've mentioned, Back to Viz Basics is not just for Tableau, but it is kind of just set up for Tableau users. I mean, as you can see, they even say here, for those newer to Tableau, create a simple chart, yada, yada, yada. Okay, so it is a Tableau project. Let's just be clear. But we're going to use it to learn more about Flourish. So the Superstore data set, if you've never used Tableau, it's the built-in data set that's used for basically almost all tutorials, right? Because everybody has the same data and it has made up data on different types of orders of products, profits, revenues, geography, has a lot of different stuff in it. As you can see here, we have sales, profit orders, region of the country, north, south, east, west, the state, the product category and the subcategory. So what I'm going to do is use the data here to just look at flows. This is what we're going to create. Create flows from each of those categories, consumer, corporate, or home office, into the different category of products. So office supplies, furniture, technology, and then into each of the specific product categories. So we're going to go from consumer, for example, consumer to office supplies to appliances. So that's what this is going to show. And if we hover on top of it, you can see that the numbers pop up for each of these so that you can see them. So what's really nice about the Sankey is that it is built in to Flourish. Now, I do believe you need maybe a pro version of Flourish. So if you don't have a pro version of Flourish, you might not be able to create this graph. So check that out. Let me know if I have that wrong. So let's go over to the data. There's a lot of data here. Here's the full data set, okay? And there are, let's go all the way down, 10,195 records. So all I want to do is get these numbers, these flows from each of these states set up and then paste it in, right? So there are a variety of ways to do that. And let's see if I can remember how I did it. I created basically a series of pivot tables. I just created a bunch of pivot tables and then pulled out the sum of the quantities so that I could create what the data that I need. And so what I mean by that is the data have to be in a specific format. So when you get to this kind of visualization where maybe you don't know how the data are structured, the best thing to do is just use Flourish to tell you what you need to do. What do I mean by that? Okay, so here's Flourish. I'm already in Flourish. I'm going to select a Sankey diagram over here. And I'm going to create this visualization. So what I want to do is almost the same kind of thing. Now they have four here. I want three. So let's go into the data and let's just figure out what they're doing. So petroleum to transportation, transportation to rejected energy, and energy services. So we've got, I already forgot, petroleum. Let's look for petroleum. Right here. So petroleum to these different ones. So let's take a look. So this is petroleum goes to these. I think there are four different categories. So petroleum, five categories. But then how do we get from transportation to the next? Well, there's transportation down here, rejected energy, energy services. So I think my thinking initially when I look at a graph like this is I'm going to have multiple columns showing each path. But in fact, all you're going to use is two columns for the beginning and the end of each path and then the number associated with that path. So again, if you're not quite sure how to set up the data for the Sankey diagram, just use the built-in template. And the built-in template's going to tell you how to set the data up. So for us, what we want, if I go all the way back, is we want, for example, consumer to office supplies, and then office supplies to these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So just to get from consumer to the end, we need to have 10 different values, right? Consumer to office supplies, and then office supplies to those 9. So when we go over to the Excel file, you can see I have consumer over to those three. So consumer to furniture, office supplies, technology. Let's go back. Consumer, office supplies, furniture, technology, right there. And then office supplies, let's go back. Office supplies needs its own set. And so now I have this data all set up. So let's just copy it. Go over to the new data. Let's just clear this out. Paste in our data. Just paste it in. Let's see what we get. And hey, look at that. That's all set. I mean, that's what we need. That's it right there. We're essentially done here, right? Now we can play around with all the legends and the colors to make this however we want to make it. But the key thing here, and this is what I really appreciate about Flourish, is that I just need to get the data in the right format. Now, again, I don't know if I love this visualization, but the point is here is to learn how to create it. So let's play around with a few other things here. Let's go into colors. You can change the opacity. We could change even the palette. Let's do something a little bit more muted. That's nice. I'm going to use that. You can see that it's adding the gradient here from one color to the next. We could, of course, change that. We could change, how the data are set up. You know, you don't even have to have the opacity. So right now this has the product on the far right is where the colors are going. But we could do it by source. We could do it like that. And this may be even a little bit clearer. Or you could set it up by target. I do not like that. I'll just leave it by node. I think that's the easiest way. Labels, you know, we could change all the different things where we want it to go. I'm not going to put the label inside. I think that looks even more cluttered. So I'm just going to leave it on the outside. We can change the pop-ups and the panels. I don't actually have anything set up here, because I don't think there's anything else to say. And we should obviously change the header here. I don't have a great header for this title. How about this? Let's do a little Tableau dig. Using Tableau's Superstore data in Flourish. We'll just do that. We'll just keep that simple. And let's also add a footer. And we'll say back to Viz Basics week number 16, I think we're on. Let's scroll all the way back to our data. This is week 16. Let's copy it and let's drop it, the link in here. And then I will be able to publish this and then you can go play with it. Publish and embed. And now it's available for you. You can obviously copy and grab the URL below in the show notes. You can head over to the all the other Back to Viz Basics pages to learn more about the project. Chime in. Let me know what you think. Try some of your own versions. And ooh, wait, before you go, don't forget to label it. I'm just going to call it something simple. Week number 16, Sankey diagram. Don't forget to name it. Makes your life a lot easier when you're in Flourish. Then you got to republish it. So I'll republish it. No problem. I'm good to go. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. I hope you're enjoying this series on making graphs in Flourish. Let me know if you have any questions, concerns, troubles, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I'll see you next time on the Back to Viz Basics Flourish Edition YouTube channel. See ya.